Hey everybody, it's 40 Warrior. Welcome back to Final Fantasy VI Advance. In the last part, we traveled all the way to Zozo, and apparently there was a girl here. And also, we can jump across buildings by doing this, as that thief up there is nicely demonstrating for us. But in here, there's Stock. Looks like we have no choice but to go in. Okay. Also in the last part, we met some really dirtbaggy enemies, such as the Veil Dancer and the Hill Gigas. Particularly the Veil Dancer, who has been none too kind to me. Luckily, I don't think it's going to matter at this point. Because this Harvester right here, duh. He's the least of your worries. Like the Gobbledygook. I hope me inspecting that urn was not the reason this happened. I don't think it was. Alright, give me the runic, you son of a bitch. Give me it. Give me it. I'm not gonna get it with my luck. Hey, I got it off. Now watch save and kill the Veil Dancer. I'm gonna keep the Veil Dancer alive now that I have the runic in play. Because maybe... Yay! It worked! That's Fira 2, by the way. That's Fire 2. And now I can actually use the Ruin Edge. Sort of like, right back at you, bitch. Because you see, by doing that, I recovered some MP and I used it right for a subsequent attack. So, not too bad, if I do say so myself. Also, that's some pretty good items. My watch second hand is pointing at the 4. That would imply 20 seconds, but of course, I've already got the item in question. The seconds are divisible by 20. That rules out a few of them. Ultimately, you'd be left with, I think, a 50-50. And I think it's like 6 hours, 10 minutes, like 30 seconds or something, and 50 seconds, which ended up being right. Oh boy. A Hill Geese and a Harvester? No thanks. No thanks. I just pray the chainsaw works. And you know what? I'm not taking any chances. Ooh, we needed that. What? Oh, he did Magnitude 8 anyway? Oh, you son of a bitch. You son of a bitch. Oh, that is bullshit. That is such bullshit. Right as he was about to die, he threw Magnitude 8 in just to troll me, and Solace is down as a result. On the bright side, locking the level. Alright. Give me a sec. Also, I have stolen a few potions, so I suppose I could use a few of them. And once again, you do remember to stock up on these, I hope. Also, cells were leveled up there too, jeez. Doesn't that always happen? I swear, in RPGs, that shit always happens. Anyway. Continuing onward. Gained a battle with Harvesters and all that. And thank you, Harvester, because Celis now gained that level. That was being somewhat elusive for some reasons. RPG reasons, as always. Man, with all the silver spectacles I'm stealing, I don't think I'm ever going to go blind ever again. Not that I've really gone blind much at all this game anyway. Dark isn't too prevalent. Burning Fist, now that is prevalent. That's a new weapon for Saban. And a much more powerful one. Oof. Fire themed. And we have this random guy up here. But first, Sam gained a level. But the really shocking thing was this. I killed the Harvester. The Harvester, as his dying breath, his dying attack, steals Gil from me. Why? Because then I just recover it back as he dies. It makes no sense. Anyway, this guy's just standing right here, and he seems to be in my way. I don't like the sound of this. Do you? Maybe it's me. But anyway, say, good sir, Azozo, could you move, please? You're kind of in my way. What brings you up here on this fine, rainy day? Do you mean to... I'm sorry, I didn't mean to be in the way. I'm not very strong in a fight, and I'd hate for there to be any trouble, so why don't I just let you pass? Well, like Garibay and Zozo, this is a liar, liar, pants on fire situation, and now we got to boss fight with Donnalumma. Well, let's kick this bitch's ass. I believe the big thing with Donnalumma is powerful physical attacks, but I don't remember. Either way, that's the way I'm going to treat this battle. Also, having Zealous in the front row and doing a Ruin Edge allows her to do spectacular amounts of damage. Oh, really? This is your thing? This is your privilege? You high potion yourself? Oh. And you do Protect. Well, now. That makes things interesting. So it looks like I beat the snot out of Donnalumma to the point where he was like, okay, time for me to go to plan B. And remember, magic is not affected by Protect, so... Ooh! Fresh meat. Namely, Iron Fists. So you know what? Let's just use a Blizzard. No, the Iron Fists don't faze me. After all, I can just do this. Donnalumma is not meant to be a very powerful, very formidable boss fight, so I'm not going to treat it like one. Donnalumma should be almost dead anyway. Right on cue. Thank you very much, Donnalumma. You're far too kind. Now, would you kindly move out of the way? Would you kindly? And with that, we acquire a Twist Headband, which was available to us before, but only a few people could wear it. And as you see, it raises your strength, your speed, your stamina, but that Green Beret is so awesome. However, anybody can wear the Green Beret, which makes it a very, very nice item. So if you want to give it to a mage, you're more than welcome to do that. But anyway, Donnalumma was preventing you from getting up here. And up here is Terra. Well, this is pretty significant. It doesn't look like she's gotten any better. She still is stuck in that Super Saiyan Esper form. And Ramu, whoever that is, says she's frightened. Ramu! Hello. This girl is your friend, I presume. Yes, she is. Terra's gone loco again. She used a power she didn't know she had, and it overwhelmed her. Now her body won't listen to what she's telling it to do. And... Whoa. That guy right there is an Esper? What the heck is going on here? So Espers live in another world, but they can live in this one all the same. They come in a variety of forms. So he looks like a human, so he could disguise himself. Okay. Humans and Espers are incompatible creatures. What he means by that is the War of Magi. Exactly. The War of the Magi. Humans and Espers fought a war against each other. Espers fought humans infused with magic extracted from other Espers. That is horrific. Wow. That is just horrific. Why is it always the humans that commit these heinous atrocities? Why is it never the other side? The other side never does anything heinous. It's always the greedy, greedy humans that are overly enterprising. Humans one day stumbled into the world of the Espers. And Gastal led the charge. Used the powers extracted to create an army. And probably is responsible for how Celis knows magic. But the Espers blocked it off. Those were captured are now in the Empire's Magitech research facility being drained of their powers. Well, now. So the Empire has captured Espers. That's why Terra is so valuable. Because it seems like they knew somehow that she is an Esper. And of course the Esper and Narsh that we saw about the Garmanda, aka Tritok. Okay, but why'd you have to pick a place like Zozo? Seriously. The place is a shithole. And dangerous, too. Now, she's a bit different. Really. He's asking a very tall order. The Magitech research facility, we gotta break in? Ugh. That can't be good. He's going to turn himself into Magicite so that we can use Ramu. That's an extreme sacrifice. But Magicite is basically, yeah, the Esper's power in his purest form. And once you acquire it, you acquire their power. These are the companions of his. So now we're going to get 4 Magicite. Ramu, and 3 others. Not Terra. Terra's not gonna move from this spot for a while. But crazy, huh? Espers, the War of the Magi, the Magitech Research Facility. Talk about a revelation. So, well, none do but to pick this up. Ramu, if his powers are used for destruction, the skies are dark and life will fade from the earth. There must not be a second war of the Magi, so that's why he sacrificed himself. Now, once we obtain all these Magi, such as Kate Sith, the Siren, and Kirin, this revelation also happens to be a revelation for the entire game. Because now, lo and behold, Edgar, Saban, and Lux suddenly have MP. And a pretty decent chunk. Well, this is probably where the gameplay part's going to end. Now I'm going to try to explain this in some way. We have these Espers. Now, these Espers are summons. Much like any other Final Fantasy, you can summon somebody and they'll do their magic, and it's usually pretty devastating. In this game, summons are actually extremely weak, relatively speaking. Now, if I was to summon... Now, you can equip Espers to these people. So, maybe I want to give Ramu to Solace. Now, when she has Ramu equipped, in battle, she can choose to summon Ramu whenever she pleases. While that is going on, you see this here. Acquisition rates, spells, Thunder, Thundara, and Poison, and progress. And at level up, you see a bonus. Depending on the Esper you equip, as you go through battles, you will gain things called magic points. The magic points will be used to help you learn certain powers. So let's say in the next battle I face, let's say I face two harvesters. I beat them, naturally. And they say I gain one magic point from that battle. What that means is Celis will progress so that she will be 10% of the way to learning Thunder, 2% of the way to learning Thundara, and 5% of the way to learning Poison. Because 1 times 10 is 10, 2 times 1 is 2, 5 times 1 is 5. And if you gain like 5 magic points, she would be halfway the way to learning Thunder. And it adds up as time goes along, so what you need is 10 magic points for Solace's case to actually learn Thunder. This is how you learn spells. And this is what I mean about you can actually typecast certain characters into being mages only. You know, offensive. Maybe you just want someone to learn Cure. Really, the choice is up to you. But the other thing you see is the level ups. Whenever Celis levels up, if she levels up with Ramu equipped, her stamina will permanently increase by 1. So, that's the other nice thing about it. Now, because I use Celis more as like an offensive battle mage, I'm going to want her to have Ramu. Because Kirin, as you see this one summon, Kirin, if I choose to equip it to somebody, if they use that summon, it'll give the party regen. Now, as you see, you can learn things like Cure, Cura, Regen, Poisona, and Libra. The only ones I really care about are Cure and Cura, personally. Cure 1, Cure 2. So, I maybe would want to give that to somebody so they can actually learn Cure. If you learn the spell, obviously, already, you'll be at 100%, so no problem. And you also can get an explanation of these. Regen's pretty easy to understand. Libra Scan. Libra is basically bestiary. Can be reflected, though, so just be careful of that. You might accidentally scan yourself. You don't want that. Unless you like scanning yourself. Magic plus 1. Confuse, Imp, and Float. Confuse just confuses you. Imp turns you into an imp. And Float is actually a pretty nice thing, which allows you to float in midair. And if you level up, your magic goes up. Pretty awesome. You can also maybe raise your HP or your MP, which is also a very sweet deal. As you see, this would allow him to learn Sleep, Silence, Slow, and Fire. Now, people like Edgar and Saban, I really don't use magic with ever, so what I typically like to do with them is get them the white magic, like Cure and Cura. But if they learn extraneous things, that's not a big deal to me. It really isn't. I don't mind if I've learned silence and sleep to learn things like fire, so be it. Not a big deal. I'm not going to lose sleep over it. But things like learning magic plus 1 for like Saban or whoever, is it really necessary? I don't know. But that's just the way it breaks out. So now you know. Anyway, I think that about does it. I'm going to try to bail out of Zozo without dying. Also, Cyan and Gaur are here. So I can circumvent a very good chunk of Zozo. Thank God. And Edgar explains to Cyan and Gao what's really going on. Of course, Gao just jumps down the building like it's a landslide. So it's very possible that Celis was infused with Espers, with a match site. And once again, you'll have the opportunity to choose your party. So Celis and Locke are going to go there, and of course Locke's probably just doing it out of Survivor's Guilt once again, and the vow to never have that happen. I'm gonna put Cyan into the party, I think. But actually, no. You know why? Because I have the Espers equipped. If you don't have those people in the party, I think they keep the Espers equipped, which means you limit your chance to actually learn some nice things. It's unfortunate, but that's just the way how it works. And unfortunately, the only way to be able to go back to change my party will be to go back to Narsh, and that's a long way away. Still, I have a good team. All this means I might have to do a little bit of grinding later on. Unfortunately. But it's such a long journey. Now, it goes without saying that those four pieces of Magicite, those four Espers, are not the only Espers you'll find. You'll just have to keep exploring around and finding new ones. So, with that, I'm going to end this part, and we'll go to Jidor in the next part. See you guys then, 40 Warriors signing off.